there is a fine line, and it's a very stressful fine line, because, you know, you're taking a, you know, real man who's a hero, and then you're sort of like doing this fictionalized take on true events, and you want to find a way to honor the man, but also the movie. So I think that was like an interesting challenge. It was great. It was, I mean, again, it was like a bit of a, it was a bit stressful for me because I didn't want to dishonor their memory of him. And I didn't, you know, so when they came to set and sort of gave us their blessing and shared all these stories about him, it was like a kind of a relief, you know, and very helpful at the same time, getting to know him, you know. I mean, he told a lot of personal stuff, which I won't share, but like just in terms of like physical details and stuff, you know, I thought one thing was interesting, which was that neither one of them had a memory of him without a cigarette, and that he was like constantly ashing into the cuff of his pants so that he wouldn't ash anywhere around him. So at the end of the day, there was this like emptying process from the cuffs of all the ashes, and they just talked about that and things like that, which I thought were interesting. The stuff that she made for us was the best. I mean, I don't think that, like, you know, she's like Academy Award winning costume designer. She works for the Coen brothers. I'm not sure that everybody in the 50s or 40s was wearing suits just like that, you know. She's the best. But we loved it. I think all of us did. And I think in some way it was like the ritual of putting it all on in the morning. And there's like kind of a lot to it that sort of helped you get your head in the game. I think it was fun for us. I don't know if it was fun for Ruben or for anyone else that had to kind of wrangle this madness, you know. And it's a real feat in editing, this movie, that they managed to cut anything serious out of what we did. You're constantly getting like a gun, you know, like riding up your leg, you know, that kind of stuff. I don't know if that's fun, but it is what it is. Ruben's the greatest too. I mean, I loved Zombieland, and I think like his approach to the movie was so interesting because he was like a history major in school, and he had a very academic approach to the historical like content in the film, and yet at the same time he was taking such liberties with it and adding this sort of like comic book quality to those events. So I think those two aspects of his personality make for like an interesting stamp on the genre. They did such a great job, and you know, I've been living in LA since I was 16, so you're always kind of like haunted by the ghost of that time and sort of imagining, you know, if you kind of, you can almost see what it was like. And then to have them kind of resurrect it in such a like a beautiful way. You know, I remember the opening scene in the movie is like a 10-minute take, and you're just like walking down the street and all the period cars and people in clothes and the dialect and the music. And then I walked into Slapsy Maxie's, and it's like an active club and people are having dinner and Carmen Miranda's on stage. And it was just like, I guess, pretty surreal at a certain point.